What up, guys? I'm with Teron here today, the master deadlifter.
I wish.
Dude, you almost pulled 800.
I'm not master until I pull 8. When I pull 8, then I'm like, all right, I can put that M right there on the Instagram.
Didn't you feel that way, though, at 7? You didn't feel like you put an M at 7?
No.
7's too pussy?
Nah, it's because I think I've hit it too much now. So it's like...
Sure. Well, yeah. I've never even... How do you feel about someone that's never hit 7 before? Can they do a little M, lowercase M?
You can do an M for... it's personal. It's a personal thing.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
so it's just like, if you hit, what, 500?
I hit...
What's the most you hit?
I hit 600 in a competition, but they didn't count it because I hitched it. But I hit 585 in the gym.
So how much of a hitch? Like...
I locked it out.
You locked it out, though? Okay, that's what matters.
Yup.
That's what matters right there. Yep. How much would you weigh?
Like 220.
220? That's good, bro.
Really?
That's good. Did I say M or W?
M.
M?
Yep.
What does M stand for?
Master. Master of deadlift. Well, today...
I'm glad he asked. I was like, damn, what does M stand for? Master.
Yeah. Today we got deadlift day. I was going to squat, but I'm with super strong deadlifter Teron here today, and so we just end up deadlifting. I needed the motivation anyways. Like these days, I've been really focusing on just the more athletic training, getting better for martial arts. So when I'm lifting, I don't have that mindset of like going ham. So seeing him go ham and the way he gets psyched out for it, I'm like, hell yeah. And it kind of like, I wouldn't say rekindle my powerlifting love, but it definitely motivates in a different way than I usually do.
But I get like a little push, you know, to just kind of, all right, let me, like, I know where I'm at here, you know, doing these movements, let me focus on a little bit more. It's like, I think, I felt like it's always good to work out with people, you know, here and there, because you start to, I think you become more balanced in your training.
Yeah.
Sometimes, you know, like, you start to realize how much you veer off from something, and you're like, all right, let me pay a little bit more attention to this while still doing this. You know, I'm like you did the athletics, I'm like, I mean, you know, I do that shit too,
yeah.
So. I would have been cool either way.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
So I'm just I'm thankful that giving me some deadlift tips and shit I need to work on, because sometimes I kind of get caught in my own ways.
Yeah.
And I just need to hear from somebody else.
Yeah. You know? Watch Teron do it.
You're about to call him Tarantino?
Huh?
You're about to call him Tarantino?
I was about to call him Tarantino, yeah. Tarantino!
Tarantino!
Dude, if you became a filmmaker.
Tarantino!
What?
I tried the whole coaching thing, but I'm just so, I get so dumb sometimes.
Why, you're like, this guy doesn't know?
No, it's not that. It's just like, especially when it comes to diet, I'm just like, yo, I'm not doing this. Yo, I'm like, I just can't. Like, I just, you want me to like, yeah, like you just like, you want me to eat this shit like every, you know, I do that. It's what's funny, because I do it for my clients.
Yeah.
And they do it, you know, they're willing to do it, but I feel like, you know, I'm just at a point where I just can't do that shit anymore.
Yeah.
You know, and.
I actually like that for having another coach. Because when I coach myself, I don't hold myself accountable as much. But when I gotta answer to someone like every other day or every week, then I feel like I gotta be better on it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Especially for me. Like if I'm doing a meet, I for sure won't coach myself. Yeah. Because I'm gonna be like, nah, I know what I need to work on, but what's more fun to me, and I always go towards what's more fun.
Exactly. That's honestly what I be. I get bored doing shit. I'm like, man, this shit is boring.
Dude, let me do that.
Let me go do that.
Let me do
sprints, even though I got deadlift, you know, tomorrow and shit, and you know, wear myself out.
Yeah. All right. So Teron, something that's part of Teron's program. What did you just tell me?
I'm supposed to be doing like max rep muscle up like every workout.
Every workout, he does max rep muscle ups. I was like, oh shit, I haven't done one in like a year or two, so I'm like, fuck it, I'm gonna try to do this. You go first.
Alright, but before you go though, any pointers on muscle ups? Stay tight, use that momentum. I use my elbows in, so everything's like boom.
Yeah.
Boom. Like letting down.
Yeah.
When I come down, it's like a swoosh, like one, and then boom. It's like you're using that momentum as you're going this way. Come back up.
If you need a rest, you rest at the top.
Yeah, you're at the bottom, I feel that pain. And I'm down like fucking up.
Is that deadlift?
This is 10.
I'm gonna try to go 5. Go try. All right, let's get it.
3, maybe.
One thing I took from you though is doing max muscle ups every day. I think I'm gonna start doing that. So I'm pretty good at pull ups, but it's different when you're doing muscle ups, and I can see how it does benefit everything, like your chest, your shoulders, your hip explosiveness. And before I kind of straight like avoided doing it just because I'm like, man, I already don't have enough time in my training to do all the things I want. But now if it's just one set, you could always add one set into any workout.
And that's enough.
Yeah, and
that's
I'll just try lot. To add one rep a day or something, see what happens.
That's exactly what I'm trying to do. It actually started out with like Kelly Muscle, like him doing like the muscle ups. And
yeah, he did almost 20.
He did, I think 15.
Oh,
he did 15.
Oh, 15. Okay.
Yeah, and he's what, 240?
Yeah.
240, he's like 40 some years old. And I'm just like, yo, that's motivation right there, you know what I'm saying? So I'm like, all right, let me get my stuff together.
Yeah.
And once I've been doing it for a while, and I stopped, and I'm coming back to it, and I'm just like, yo, this really, it feels good.
Yeah.
Even when I did it for the start of a workout, like, it got me warmed up and, like, ready for, you know, a chest or, you know, arm workout.
Yeah.
So, I just throwing it in there.
Yeah. Do you ever have any shoulder issues?
I never had any shoulder issues. Ever since, 3 years ago, I went to Olympia, and I did a muscle up, and then I went into a handstand, right?
On a bar?
Yeah, on a bar.
Oh, shit.
And then I, instead of going back down, back down this way, I went the opposite way. So if I would've went that way, my hand grip would've eventually came out. So I had to quickly switch to keep myself from busting my face into the ground. And I couldn't lift my arm for almost a year. Dude, this is as far as I could go. And that was the only injury I've ever had from doing calisthenics shit. But other than that, no.
What I was gonna say is what I noticed about people that do a lot of muscle-ups or a lot of pull-ups in general, they usually have no shoulder injuries. When you're doing a lot of benching and pressing, your shoulders start coming forward.
Yeah.
But if you're not balancing it out with the pull-ups, then your shoulder comes forward and you get hurt. But most people that I hear that are good at pull-ups have no shoulder injury. I've never had shoulder pains in here ever.
No?
Yeah, never.
I felt it get tight before.
Yeah.
But as far as pain, nah.
Yeah, yeah.
Nah. Sometimes I feel weird when I bench because I got no traps, so I look like.
You don't have traps?
No, I don't have traps.
Oh, yeah, you don't actually. That's one thing I noticed. I'm like, oh shit.
I don't have traps.
To match your arms, it should be right here, I think.
I don't know how to train traps. I do shrugs, I do cleans, I do all that shit. Sorry if I spit.
No worries.
And they just don't grow, you know? I just.
Try dumbbells, isometric pulse. Hold it for 5 seconds and then come down.
I've done those too.
You have?
Yeah, with hundreds.
Damn.
Some hundreds. Strap it up.
Everything about injecting protein directly into it?
I don't like protein
that. Like optimum nutrition?
I think I'm allergic to protein.
Really?
I'm a carb person.
You get diarrhea?
Nah.
Throw up?
I'm intolerant to beef.
For real?
Yeah.
Oh shit. What do you mean?
I did one of those blood tests.
Yeah.
And it told me everything you're intolerant to.
So
I'm intolerant to corn, barley, and beef.
Oh damn.
Yeah, but I still eat beef. That's why I get so I still eat beef. I'm not even the lightest intolerance. I'm the highest. I'm very intolerant to beef. And I always wonder why I'm always bloated.
Yeah.
I'm just so bloated all the time. I can never digest beef properly. But
it tastes too good, huh?
Yeah, bro. Especially with pasta. I eat a lot of pasta.
Yeah.
4 times a week.
Damn.
Yeah.
So, you're already big as fuck to me. I wanted to know if you had any heroes or idols that you're because to me, I'm that's the end goal, right? If I could get 19, so I'm dude, that's me being a billionaire. I wouldn't care about being a trillionaire or anything. For you, do you have an idol or a hero?
Not anime.
Not a real life person.
Yeah.
Good
Batman.
Good enough.
Yeah.
Batman.
No, a real life person, dude.
Is Batman not real life?
No. When you're growing up,
real
were you
life
like
person.
Damn, I want to be that
football
guy.
Player, bodybuilder,
boxer.
Body
all around body movement, Michael Jai White.
Oh, yes. He's a good one. He's jacked as fuck.
He's jacked as fuck. Martial arts, his splits and shit. I'm yeah. That's why I'm really trying to find time to get back in. Cause I did Taekwondo for 4 years. So I've been trying to get back into that.
Yeah.
And it's just been tough. Just trying to bounce out that time for. Yeah, but I feel you know what the problem is? I have so much time during the day, but then again, I don't. But I feel I do have 2 hours to spare for martial arts every day.
Yeah.
You know, because I want to get my black belt. I'm still trying. I'm still definitely going to get my black belt. But yeah.
Taekwondo?
Yeah, definitely Taekwondo.
Michael Jai White's a really high level karate black belt. I think third degree or fourth degree.
I think he's the same thing in Taekwondo as well.
Yeah.
He's done four styles.
Yeah.
So, but yeah.
Have you ever met him?
Nah, I've never met
him. He's like your size.
Yeah. We've talked on Instagram before.
Oh, that's cool.
Because I did a post and he commented, and I think Wesley Snipes commented, and I think he commented also, because I did Blade.
Yeah.
And then they were saying I could be something for Michael Jai White, play a son in a movie or some shit.
Oh, that's tight. So,
everybody trying to get me to play Mr. T, son, in Creed.
Oh, that'd be tight.
I'm like, yo, get your boy out.
You want to do it or they told you to do it?
They told me to do it, but I want to do it.
Yeah.
That'd be
awesome.
Hell yeah, bro.
Yeah.
Well, in fact, I met Michael B. Jordan before. One of my friends is his trainer.
Yeah.
So
he's pretty jacked too. Yeah.
He's cool. He's small.
He's cool. He just looks ripped, so he looks good on camera.
Yeah. Yeah, but yeah, they made my boy Corey. He got him crazy ripped for the movie. So, but yeah. Creed 3, y'all. Creed 3.
They're making one?
I'm pretty sure they're gonna make a Creed 3. Yeah, for a fact, that's too good.
So Sylvester Stallone's alive, he'll keep making them. And then Creed will have a son, and the son will keep making movies too, all the way.
Well, there you go, yeah. The generation moves on. I mean, hell, we got what? How many Star Wars now? 10?
11.
11? 10? 10 with what?
10 with Rogue One.
With Rogue One? Yeah, so I would love to be in a Star Wars movie too. That would be like my dream. If I ever made it in a Star Wars movie, my life is set.
Just sneak on set.
Just be on set?
Yeah.
Just get coffee from people.
Just get coffee?
Yeah.
Like, bro, I'll ever. I just want one role. Like, I can get shot, I don't care. I can be a stormtrooper, I don't give a fuck.
Well, thank you guys for watching our workout. It was Ty connecting with Teron. Super strong, super athletic. Go check them out. How can they see your channel?
You
down here?
You use your eyes.
True. Ears too, maybe.
You can see me at Teron 2311. And appreciate you guys. I didn't even know we were filming. I just thought we was going to shoot, but yeah, but fuck, I appreciate it. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And it's always good coming to the gym, dude. Like, I've been enjoying LA, and you know, you guys are a big part of it, and you know, it's just, I might move to Vegas, but yeah.
Shit.
And for you guys, you can definitely check out the Barbell Brigade channel.
Thank you.
Make sure you actually come here, all right? If you visit, I see a lot of people ask me like, yo, Teron, where should I go in LA to visit for the gym? Right here, all right? Definitely check this gym out. It's very motivated. Everybody's in here working. This is not one of the gyms where you really see people bullshitting around, and like everybody's in here to work and motivating each other. And
I'm the only one bullshitting usually.
Yeah, pretty much. You too. But much love, y'all.
Peace.